karibuni sana. Tutaanza na mimi kama the meaning of the word Menengai. So jina Menengai ni jina ya Kimasai, which inamaanisha vifo vya watu wengi. So the last eruption happened here. The Maasai were caught in the middle of that volcanic eruption. So a lot of Maasai died here. So when you were back, wakaita mlima Menengai. Kuna Maasai hapa?
Hello.
So Menengai ni kumaanisha vifo vya watu wengi ni Maasai, Menengai. So when the Kikuyu settled here, so they were not able to pronounce that word Menengai. So wakaita Menengai. So originally it came from the Maasai. So hii mlima tunaita Menengai Crater. But a good geographical term, hii tunaita Menengai Caldera. Juu caldera is a huge depression of the volcanic area. So most of people, or maybe for the expectation, watu walikuja hapa wanakuja to believe that wanaona shimo, then kuna moshi hapo chini. So that's not a difference. So a good geographical term, then you say, hii ni caldera. A crater is a volcanic mountain with that depression of the na kweza inakaa kama funnel. Example ni kama long road. So hii mlima ilikuwa juu kabisa. Ilikuwa inaitwa Mount Menengai. So hot up ile kulikuwa na volcanic eruption. Wakati hiyo magma ilitoka chini, kuna some point kukaachwa na void, like empty. So hot up ile na mountain collapse. At least in the first formation of the crater. Then some point kukaachwa na void, and then also Menengai. It was like about 7 times. Catch of the question at Lalo. So we cover 90 square kilometers of the area of the questions. We come up to the rim of the question, you will call the way around 90 square kilometers. Then we come up upon a team with 500 meters. That's like 1500 feet. Then from this point to the other side, 15 kilometers. So meaning that caldera is the second largest caldera in Africa, Tangorongosa, in Tanzania. So it is the second largest. They told you 90 square kilometers, then 15 kilometers diameter. So the eruption happened here, it was 400 years ago. You can get a chin on your black part. You are like the magma. So you can look at you even flow all the way down. You can get a chin on your steam. That's behind the steam for your camera. So that's the point of the cinder cone. Initially happened before the bench. I'm going to call the epicenter of the mountain. You remember that I told you the mountain collapsed. So your point catch your bad to eco. When you go there, you claim that cinder cone, you can be able to see the entire depression. But now it's a blocked event. So the pressure end up like a form, you're swallowing. So that it's a blocked event. So you can go all the way down. That's like 400 years. So since 400 years, this mountain has been dormant. We have three types of volcanic mountain: dormant, extinct, and active. So Menengai is one of the dormant volcanoes. Means some years to come, maybe it has a chances of eruption. And the chances of eruption, maybe late in the evening, you find some steams that are up a chin. This is the corner of the Kitambo when the Kikuyu settled here. So I can't say my devils and ask a motor of chin. So I can't take him off the Akoma, like a mountain of devils. So these are two steams. So what about the steams? There's fumaroles, geysers, hot swing, and steam gates. So many guys are part of fumes. Na sometimes ukienda huko chini uta smell sulfur. Juu hiyo gas inatoka inatoa sulfur huko chini hiyo steam.
I love KQ music. Yeah.
sana sikuwe. Kuna safari zingine huwa unaenda nikisha fika tivu unapata mungina asha kwa mgonjwa inapida hivino kusuri ya saendo sikitali tena hatu wake buwana sikuwe. Kuli imekua salama bado tungali wazimba tunashukuru buwana sikuwe. So God has a reason for you to come in this place. And the reason for you to come here is you just to come and see and just explore. One has feel. You have a reason. God has a purpose for you. When you meet pale chini, tumeona wameandika pale that do not let the fire do it. Go off the altar, the fire on altar. Go off, praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. And which fire? It is the fire of the Holy Spirit. One has feel. Mm-hmm. And for you to make it, ready to go off, you should. In a full way, catalyze, you make it active. How? You have to praise Him, you have to worship Him. One has a feel. And the Bible says that not everything that has breath, praise Him. It does not describe whether it is bad, but anything that has breath, worship Him, praise Him, one has a feel. Mm-hmm. If there is anything that you should give God, it is a praise. You have to worship Him, one has a feel. Mm-hmm. And then it says in John, that those who, it is coming a day, for those who will be after, those who worship Him in truth and in what? In spirit. So if you worship Him in spirit, worship Him in truth. So before I encourage you with the word of God, I would like my sister just to sing again. Tuseme ni asante. Kila mtu ujapo ni raisi. Watu wengi walikufa wenye tulianza kusoma nao, primary, secondary, colleges and campuses. Some of them died, even our teachers died, ministers are dying, and other great people are dying. Praise the Lord. But wewe una pesa hata, family wena ajiwezi, but God has kept you well. Mm-hmm. We have a reason to thank God, Bwana asifiwe. Yes, it's not that we are able to pay Him, but it is just because of His mercy and His favor and His love. So the Bible says, for so they love the world. So He loved you. He loved you and still loves you up to now. That's why He has given you a chance in your life. Sio kwamba vitu ambavyo tumefanya ni vyema, sio ambao maneno tumeongea kwa gari ni mazuri, sio kwamba vile ambavyo tumeona ni vizuri, tumetamani hadi Bwana asifiwe. So mimi ningependa please utatuimbia hiyo wimbo tunasema ni asante. And then take your time just to thank God, pray. Unajua kwamba si lazima you don't have a reason to read vocabulary ndio Mungu asikie, no. It just communicate, have your personal communication with God. Thank God. Kukubeba kuchua kule, kufikisha hapa, nyumbani, familia ni wazima, hadi wengine vigamaza skin fish, but we are saved and we are okay, we are here. But we thank God, because the Bible says, on His mountain shall be done what? Provided. So we are on His mountain, we are on His altar. We are after provision, one of three. So let us pray for financial breakthrough, for divine protection, and even for divine generosity as we go back to our school.